Hello, my name is Mike Ansan. Welcome to Natural Health Naturally. The questions I get asked most is, how do I cook or prepare foods for vegans or vegetarians? And I'm going to show you today how to make quick snacks or starters just by using a few ingredients from your cupboard. So today we'll be making money bags just by using saltfish, a tin of ackee, which is this one, and a few bits of herbs and spices. And most importantly, we'll be using Chinese spring roll pastry. All right, first of all, just make a bit of space here. So you've got your saltfish, which you would have boiled for at least 30 minutes just to get all the salt out of the fish. And what we're gonna do is take the skin off and take off any bones or anything that's left over from it. After you've deboned the fish and taken the skin off, you need to get scallion, whether it's just one piece or just half a piece, and we just need to chop that as finely as you can and add it to the saltfish. And then we get our pepper, red pepper, yellow pepper, green pepper, doesn't matter what colour it is, just give it a wash. Of it. Right, we don't need a lot of it, it's only just to give it a bit of colour and taste. And slice it long ways. That goes in there. And next we chop up the thyme, don't need much of it, just throw a few bits in there, just give it flavour. And with this you don't need to add any salt at all because the fish is obviously salted itself. Add a bit of Maggi liquid. And then you add the ackee. Spoon. Make sure all the flavours are in there together. Taste it, of course. Make sure it tastes nice. I think it needs more flavour, so I would put fish sauce in there. Give it an extra kick. And if you've got a scotch bonnet, if you like your food very flavoured, very spicy, you can add a scotch bonnet in there. I won't do that today. What I'm going to do is add some coriander, which you chop finely as well, and then you add it in there. So what's going to happen when we actually start to fry this, you're going to taste all the flavours, from the coriander to the thyme. This is the pastry we're going to be using. You only need about, if you can take about one, two, about four sheets of it. Okay, so when you're cutting the pastry, you need to cut into four. So you need a long strip in the middle, all the way down, and down the middle. Which gives you your four pieces. And then you will need a long strip . You better to use a chopping board, and you need to get a long strip from this, and this is what we're going to use to tie the money bags with. So just cut up about at least 3 to 4 of these. And that should do it. Those are your strips, you've got your squares. And now we're ready to start putting our fillings in. So first and foremost, you need just one of your square pieces. And egg wash. Obviously use a brush, but I can't seem to find mine today. So just use your hands, or a spoon, whatever you feel would be handy. And you put another sheet on top, not together, but as a hexagon. Get another egg on there. And then you need to make a square piece out of this. I'll just show you. And cut it again. And we'll use this to put in the middle. This is what holds it together to stop it, when you're frying it, doesn't go all over the place and doesn't fall apart. This keeps it whole. So you put that in the middle, and then you get your mix. Taste it again just to make sure it's got all the flavours in it that you need. And just a little bit, just put that in the middle, right there. Don't need much of it, just a little bit. And then you put your egg wash just around the sides. And just pinch the edges with your hands. Just grab it from the bottom. And you don't want it to be baggy, you want it to be as tight as it can. So you just twist it. It's pastry, this is the type of pastry you can actually play with. It's not going to split, it should stay and hold. And then you get your strip, and this is to make sure it stays in its place. And that needs to be egg washed as well. And we just finally just use that to just go around the edges. As tight as you can. And it should just hold by itself. And then what we do, just a cornmeal polenta flour. And you just put that in an actual bowl that you're going to put your money bags in. And what this does, it supports it from being sticky or anything like that. So when you put it in the freezer, it freezes without it being stuck when you're trying to get it out. So as soon as you get it from the freezer, it will just come up very easily. And just make as much as you can. And here we have our money bags. Nice, frozen, and ready to be fried. I just need to fry this for about 2 minutes, not long. And that will just generally just cook itself. Just for about two and a half minutes left, and that's it, take it out. As you can see, it's starting to go brown. I know that's cooked, but because the inside might still be hard, I'll leave it in there for another minute or so. Make sure you turn it. So it's all coated in the oil. Be careful, it does bubble up sometimes, the oil, so be careful. This is how it should look really when it's finished. It's got that golden colour, it's still maintaining its shape. And when you break it up, you've got all the goodness inside, with all the colours and everything else.